Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Harshana Bijlani, Medical Head, Ageless Clinic. We as Indians tend to get pigmentation. So today's talk, I'm going to talk to you all about pigmentation. I'm going to cover what is pigmentation, what are the causes of pigmentation, what can we do about the pigmentation in terms of treatments, and help prolong your treatment after you've had it done. So starting with the first thing, what is pigmentation? Pigmentation is just a technical term, which is darkening of skin. So dark circles, acne marks, sun tanning, that all comes under the umbrella of pigmentation. Freckles is another very common thing that all comes in the umbrella of pigmentation. The second thing is, what causes pigmentation? Why is it that I get pigmented? So we have certain pigment cells. Our pigment cells really get attracted to sun, and that's why they come out on the surface and we look darker. So that's tanning. We are exposed to a lot of sun in our country. So the number one cause of pigmentation that I have seen is sun exposure. The second cause is genetics. So let's say dark circles. Sometimes I see young 20-year-olds who have pigmentation or darkness under their eyes, but in their family, everyone has that. So genetics plays a very important role. The third thing is certain marks that have been left behind. So let's say a chickenpox scar or a pimple scar. So that mark is also called pigmentation. The fourth is certain medical type of pigmentations, which I'm not going to get into detail. And the other causes are freckles, sunspots, age spots, all these come under pigmentation. The sixth and really important cause of pigmentation is friction. This is something that I see in a lot of my patients. So let's say, for example, I sleep on this side. Or let's say, for example, every time I sweat, I take a towel and I scrub my face like it's a vessel, I'm going to cause pigmentation. Some people say, but I've been doing it since I was a kid, doc. Why is something happening to me now? Because as we grow older, our skin becomes less forgiving. So frictional pigmentation. I'm going to touch upon a very important cause of pigmentation, and that is melasma. I don't know how many of y'all may know of melasma, but it's called the mask of pregnancy. Why is it called the mask of pregnancy? It's because we see a lot of pregnant women, or women who are going through menopause, or women who are on the contraceptive pill or any sort of hormonal medication, tend to get this pigmentation. So where do we get this pigmentation? We tend to get it on our cheeks, a little bit on the nose, on the cheeks here. So these are the typical areas, but one can get it on the upper lip, one can get it above the eyebrows, one can get it on the jawline as well. So this is a kind of pigmentation that you really need to take care of, because a lot of it has got to do with your hormones and your genetics, which we can't go in and change. But what we can change is our sun exposure. So let's say I have a tendency to get melasma, but I don't take care of the sun, I don't put sunscreen during my pregnancy, I'm just out and about, I don't take care of myself, then your tendency goes up that much fold. So if you know there's a genetic tendency for melasma, please start taking care before it appears, because prevention is much better and much simpler than trying to treat the melasma. So in conclusion, what I'd like to touch on is, don't just think your clinic treatments are the end all and the be all for your skin. Make sure that you use good quality home care and you take care of the sun. So stay tuned and stay glamorous.